So I welcome everybody. Hello friends. Welcome to yet another awesome session by Mindful Living. Thank you all for taking out your time and joining us today. We will really appreciate you investing your time with us. Is it okay if I begin by asking you a question? Please type Y in the chat box. So are we all set to, start this creative journey today? Please, I want you to type yes. Please type yes in the chat box, please. So let me, introduce you to our awesome creative speaker today. Our speaker for today is Badal Suchak, who has a bachelor's degree in alternate medicine, and he's a certified therapeutic art life coach working in creative field since last 25 years. Today, he is offering a special workshop for Mindful Living community. It will give us an introduction to art therapy and how it benefits you. So may I request Badal to, take on the session from here. Badal, over to you.
Thank you, Ashmita. And I'm grateful to Ashish for inviting me to offer my gift of art therapy to the Mindful Living community. I welcome you all with a warm heart, and would like to begin with a small activity where we will welcome everyone with a warm heart. Just turn on your cameras for some time. Keep yourself on mute. And just, thank you. Is some more cameras on, I need to be on. We'll spend a minute just looking at everyone's eyes, one after the other. Spend a few seconds looking into the eyes of each and every participant, 3 to 5 seconds per participant, and send very loving vibrations to them. Look at them with a very soft, gentle, loving gaze. Your eyes are the windows to your soul. So when you look at somebody with love, you're connecting with the person's soul. So just gently look into each one's eyes and mentally welcome that person into this space and wish them well. It is my intention that may all benefit from today's session. Just gaze into everyone's eyes. You're connecting to each one's soul. Gently gaze and welcome them with your heart. Thank you very much. This is a session where, Ashmita, you can now put me on the sharing mode, single screen mode, speakers mode. So this is a session where I'll introduce you to art therapy. And also we will have an experience of how art therapy works in your life. And I will share with you some details about my upcoming workshop, and it will be followed by any question answers if you have. So art therapy basically works on the premise that creating a work of art has a deep impact on your mental state. It clears confusion, gives clarity of mind. It helps you see any issue from a special, different perspective, from a higher perspective. It also heals your emotion. It's a good tool to heal your emotions. It gives it and brings about peace and mental well-being. So whether you create a work of art, or whether you see a work of art, or you imagine, or you visualize, anything that you do with an image is very, very healing. We'll begin with a small activity because everyone is from a mindfulness community. I thought of combining mindfulness and art. And art meaning not something which is very, very difficult to do. If we, the kind of skill sets we would have developed as school kids is good enough. Even if we can just hold a pencil and doodle around, that's good enough for art therapy, because the focus is on not accuracy in skill, but the focus is on being authentic. Being focus is on self-expression, very, very honest self-expression. According to the principles of art therapy, according to the instructions given. So activities are designed to bring about wellness. So I'm going to share with you my screen. All of you would have some A4 size blank sheets, so you can fetch them, and any color pencil or pen. And I'm going to share my screen with you. Can you see the orange screen now? Yeah, all right. Yeah, so we're going to see how mindfulness and art can be combined, how breath and a simple doodle can be combined, right? Because so you see, in most meditations, you are asked to first focus on the breath so that you are centered and you come into the present moment. We'll see how breath and a doodle can be combined together. And let's see what happens. You are all ready with your pen and paper. In the next screen, you can see when you need to draw something like this. You begin from one point, and when you breathe in, focus on your breath. When you breathe in, draw, pull the line up. When there is a pause in your breath, pull the line down. So breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Very natural breath. Breathe in, breathe out, your own breath. And if maybe if you're distracted at times, it might just go off, but you will notice that it might even deepen. So just focus on your breath for a minute and draw this line along with the breath and see what happens. Go ahead.
Badal, we have some comments in the chat box.
Yes.
Somebody is saying breath is...
You can share the comment and feedback, please.
Sure, Mr. Ramesh, if we can have you speak.
Yeah, we'd like to have this as an interactive workshop. So please go ahead and share.
As we draw, breathe and draw, our length, breath is getting longer.
How nice. Wonderful. So you're coming into the present moment. Your breath is a bridge between your head and your hand, right? Your creativity. So there's a combination of creativity, breath, and art, right? And your hand. So it's a very nice way to come into a present moment and to focus. And I would suggest that when you just have some a few minutes waiting for a meeting or just want to doodle, try this. It will calm you down, relax you. And it's a very simple doodle. In fact, I have an entire workshop on mindful doodling. So this is one of the activities which we do there, right? Anybody else would like to share?
We have Mr. Jagdish, Kamakshi Sood. They also saying it's same, but we really want you to speak. You can just share your experience with us.
All right. So the thing is, your breath could be like this, or if you are in love, it could be like that. Actually, what you've just done is you created your own cardiogram, right?
Badal, we have Ms. Reema Khanna saying, when I get distracted, the pattern changes.
Of course it will. Right. So that's all right. You just have to be honest and authentic. The more you practice focusing on your breath, more you will come into the present moment and you'll be more meditative. So this is how art helps you get into a meditative zone, into a relaxed zone, into the present moment, right? Okay, I'm going to share with you an image. Okay, can you see? What is it that you see? Can somebody turn on the mic and say?
Cake.
Cake with fruits.
Yes, and what kind of thoughts emerge in your mind when you see this?
Tasty.
Sweet and sour.
Okay. You have a memory of the cake, so and you know that it's tasty, so you think about it, yes.
Sweet and sour.
Sweet and sour, okay.
Getting tempted.
Yeah, so that's a feeling, yeah? What kind of feelings do you do come up in your mind? That you're getting tempted to eat. Yeah, there's a feeling of craving over there.
Yes.
Yeah, all right. And what do you get any, when you crave, do you get any bodily sensations? Do you get a watering mouth? You know, your mouth starts watering.
Yes, that's right.
So what happens when you want to eat the cake? Yeah.
Yeah.
So what you see is, it's a very simple way of making a point that an image, when you see an image, it pulls out a memory from your subconscious mind, right? That this is a cake. You experienced a cake before in life. So that pulls out some image from your subconscious mind, a memory, right? And it gives you some thoughts associated with it. Oh, this is a delicious cake. This is a fruit cake. This is a sweet and sour cake, right? Maybe you might also say, oh, it's so sweet, I can't have it, I'm a diabetic. Or, oh, it's fasting, I can't have it because I've got cholesterol. So those are the various thoughts that come up. It's made with generate thoughts, right? It also generates an emotion. Like, I wish to have it, you know. It's such a delicious one. I crave for it. I'd love to have it. So that is an emotion. Or if you're a diabetic, it's maybe a confused emotion. I want to have it, but I can't have it. So that is a kind of emotion. There's a bodily sensation. Mouth starts salivating. Right? So an image is associated with mind, emotions, and body. So this is the basic principle on which art therapy works. Right? When you see an image, the light travels through your eyes into your brain. It forms a memory. It pulls out a memory. It is associated with thoughts. It is associated with emotions and body. So in art therapy, we are going to work with images to connect with our mind and heal our mind. Right? You'll see as we go ahead and do an activity how we are going to do that. The second point I'd like to make is that all these images, all these memories are stored in our subconscious mind. Our mind is like an iceberg. Conscious mind is just a small portion, maybe about 15-20%, but about 80-85% is a subconscious mind. And so much of information is stored there, whether pleasant images or unpleasant images. So we have to be very mindful of that. And art therapy works on all these images stored in your subconscious mind. The second point I'd like to make is out of all our five senses, the sight, the touch, smell, taste, or hearing, the sense of sight is very important because 80% information which goes into our brain is received from the sense of sight. So it's extremely important. The third point I'd like to make is if you see paintings on the walls of caves, which ancient human beings have created, you see that they are images, that they are not words. So even before human beings started getting into language, there was a visual communication. So our brains are hardwired into communicating and processing images. Right, so that these are the premises on which art therapy works, and so if, what is this, the next image which you see? Somebody unmute and say.
Bitter gourd.
Okay, what karela, kind of thoughts come up in your mind?
Not a very great impression. I mean, bitter, karela.
So again, the thought, first of all, you recognize it as karela because you've experienced it and you've labeled it as karela. So your mind labels it, right? So there are thoughts about it. There is an emotion attached with it. that, oh, it's not a nice thing to have, right? It's an unpleasant thing. Or there is another thought, which is maybe it's bitter, but it's healthy. Its juice is very healthy. It can cure diabetes, so I must have it. So there are a lot of things going in your mind when you see an image. So whether when you see an image or whether you create an image or you visualize. Now try and visualize your favorite person in the world, your role model. What happens when you visualize your role model? Can somebody tell me? Unmute and share. Somebody whom you really admire, that kind of person, if you visualize, what happens?
We get positive feeling.
Sorry, say that again.
We get positive feeling.
You get positive feeling. So there are, and now try and imagine somebody really villainous, somebody who's really harmed you or hurt, tried to hurt you or be negative. What kind of thoughts?
Irritations.
Yeah.
You feel irritated.
Yeah, it's a stressful experience in your mind, right? So we store a lot of these stressful images in our mind. Yeah, and we feel that it's all right. It's pretty much normal. And we kind of brush it aside under the carpet. We say, we don't want to look at it. Let's just go ahead with life. But what happens is, over a period of time, it gets collected. And there are possibilities that it can get into a state of crisis. It can give you a lot of stress which you may not be able to handle at times, or some phobia, or some anxiety, or depression, some sort of panic when you're faced with that situation. Yeah? So we don't want to be in such a state of crisis. We'd rather choose to, when you have a choice to be brilliant and to be positive, you don't want to go into the crisis stage, right? When from what we consider normal, with all these stressful images stored in our mind, we want to move into a brilliant and amazing and thriving space. We don't want to move into a crisis or psychosomatic space, right? So that's how art therapy is a tool to help you become a brilliant person. It works on the principles of positive psychology, from being normal to being amazing, from being just simply good to being great. So that's a choice we can make, right? So art therapy will help you delete negative images in your brain and install positive ones. Will help you in a complete self-transformation. Just how a caterpillar turns into a butterfly. It's such a transformation process and it becomes a beautiful one. So you convert yourself into a beautiful being through art therapy as a tool. Of course, there are other tools also. Art therapy is one of the tools which really helps you combine head, heart, and body, your hands, and by creating a work of art, seeing a work of art, or visualizing a work of art, it really helps in the process of self-transformation. We'll now actually experience how this works, right? Can you pull out one more sheet of paper, which you have? And make a list of 10 daily activities which you do in your life. 10 activities, for example, it could be like cooking, cleaning, business meetings. On an average day, what is it that you do? Exercising, eating, socializing, sleeping, praying, gardening, driving, arguing, dancing, watching TV, listening to music, things like that, right? What is it that you do on an average day? Largely about 10 to 15 activities. Can you list them down? And once you've listed them down, you can also put these green arrows for any activity which lifts up your energy, which makes you feel really positive. Any activity which is stressful. So for anything that lifts up your energy, put a green arrow pointing upward. Any activity which is stressful, put a red arrow pointing downward. And any activities which is neutral, you do not have any special you wake fairly calm and doesn't impact you too much, put a yellow dot. Something that you've been managing.
I have a question. Yes, eating and socializing, you mentioned over there neutral, but usually
it depends on you. For you, it is energizing or stressful, you can do that. This is my list. For each one, the list will be different.
It will differ from people to people. If I love eating, I will give it a green arrow.
Yes.
And if I love socializing, I will give a green arrow.
Yes.
But if I have guests at home, I will give a red one. Because I'm the one who's supposed to cook and serve everybody, so I would rather give a
right. So everyone's list has to be their own. You don't have to copy this list.
Okay.
It's important to just observe what is happening in your daily life. Be aware.
Okay.
Make sure, I mean, you have to be aware of which one is green arrow, red arrow, and yellow dot. Once you've done, can somebody share their list if they wish to? So I just know that we are on a...
Ms. Reema, we want you to speak on your experience, because I can see your chat. You're putting something in the chat. If we can just speak up. Ms. Reema?
Yeah, actually I noticed that while writing down the activities, I realized that I enjoy doing everything and there was nothing neutral. So I'm wondering if I'm being truthful, but these are my daily activities.
Okay.
So I hope that's normal. I mean,
that's very good, actually. Very, very good. But do you have anything in your life which is stressful? Maybe not, it's not a daily thing, but if there is any one thing which is stressful, you can note that down. So we are making this list. So going ahead, we are going to try and see if we can convert that stressful activity into a positive one, right? Something which is stressing you, can we convert that into a positive thing?
Okay, thank you.
So pick up any stressful activity. Anyone would like to share? Anyone else would like to share the list?
I would like to share.
Yes.
Actually, I just noted a few things, but most of them are kind of, you know, mixed feelings. As in, there is a point in my day where I try to motivate myself to do something new or something, but I kind of find it stressful also because I cannot find myself actually working on it.
So
what can we do in that?
No, when you're trying something new, it is stressful. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, as in I'm trying to motivate myself to start something.
Okay. All right. So to initiate some new activity or some new experience which is stressful. So all right, we'll make a note of that. We'll see how we can convert that into something which you feel inspired to do.
Yes, and also when I'm trying to start something, I also feel that, you know, as I told before, I find it stressful as well.
So initiating a new activity is what you feel find stressful. We'll see how to convert that. Thank you for sharing. Okay. Anyone else? Okay. All right. So everyone has selected one activity. Select one activity which you want to convert into a positive one. One red arrow activity which you want to convert into a green arrow. Select one of them. Yeah, and then take another, what initially we spoke about, an image connected with thoughts and feelings and body. So we're going to try and put this situation in a visual form now and see how it works on our mind, emotions, and body, right? Okay, so now take another sheet of paper horizontally and fold it into three parts. Hold it horizontally and fold it into three parts like that and open it up then. So you see the crease, so the three equal parts. And with a pencil, draw a head in one part, draw a heart in the second part, and a body in the third part. It's very simple to draw this. Body might be difficult, so you just draw something like a gingerbread man, such a simple one. Very simple art. You don't have to be artists to benefit out of this activity. Once done, just let me know, raise a thumb, so then we can move on to the second step.
Done.
All right. So now just leave this paper in front of you and just close your eyes for a minute and bring to your conscious awareness that particular stressful situation in life.
You are not audible, actually, can you please, the paper sounds are coming.
Yeah, please mute yourself. Only when you have to speak and share, please unmute. Keep your videos on. So what you have to do is now, if you've drawn a head, heart and body, just leave it in front of you for now and close your eyes and bring to your conscious awareness that stressful situation in life. Just be completely aware of the stressful situation. What kind of thoughts are associated with this situation? When you are in that situation, what kind of thoughts emerge in your mind? Be aware of that. If those thoughts were an object or an image, how would that look like? Would you represent it with some color? Some scribbling or squiggles or some lines or dots or colors? How would it look like? Any texture? Any form? How would that thought pattern look like? Focus on the emotions which emerge in your heart when you are in that situation. How do you feel when you are in that situation? Does it make your heart throb? Does it give a sinking feeling in your heart? Does it feel some sort of stress or a complexity in your heart? Does it give a palpitation? How does it feel? And again, if it were an image, how would it look like? Would you be able to associate that with any color or a pattern or a texture?
It's palpitation for me.
Yeah, right. And focus, bring your awareness to your body in that situation. What happens in your body when you are into that situation? Is there any tightness, or does it feel relaxed? Does it feel warm or hot? Does it feel itchy, or how does it feel in your body when you are in that situation? Do you feel confused, start scratching your head? Or does it give kind of thinking feeling in your tummy? Does your head pain? What happens when you are in that situation? And try and give it a visual representation. Open your eyes and take a look at the screen. I'll just give you an idea of what I've chosen for myself, the situation of driving, which is very, very stressful for me. And while I'm driving from my home to my office, it's an hour, hour and a half long drive with a huge traffic jam. And my head is cluttered with too many thoughts. So I kind of represent it with in this way, right? And my heart is filled with so much of chaos in there and so much of palpitation. And, you know, it's a very unpleasant feeling. I represent it with zigzag here and squiggles here. And dots there, and very dull colors. Sorry, I can't hear you clearly. Are you asking any question? And in my head, there is stress in my head. And I've represented it with zigzag red lines. There is a little spiral feeling in my tummy. my knees and feet pain because of constant pedaling. So I've represented it in this way. You can choose to represent visually your feelings, your thoughts, feelings, and body sensation in whatever way you like in a simple manner. Right? Can you please do that? Is this clear? If you have any questions, you may please feel free to ask. You don't have to copy this. You have to do your own.
Yeah. No, kindly show it on the screen. We're not able to see what you have done. There was no screen sharing. So
there's no screen. Ashmita is something. Can you unmute Ashmita? Unmute yourself and just tell me what's
up. We can see your screen.
No, we can see your screen.
Okay.
We can see.
Yeah. Because my screen is being shared. That's what I can see on my screen.
I can only see you talking. I can't see the art.
So you have to, doing it from your mobile, then you just have to scroll it. You'll find it.
Okay.
Since it's from your mobile, you just have to scroll it.
Okay.
One of the picture, you'll see this. Or you have to do a speaker view. There is option of, you know, doing a view, speaker view.
Yeah, I got it right now. Thanks.
Yeah, thanks. Badal, please continue.
Yes. So if anyone has drawn this, would you like to just share what you've drawn on the screen? Unmute yourself, or if you wish to share the image that you've drawn.
Only your way of representation is in our mind, because you have caught all the things in a pictorially clean way.
Okay, if you want to hold the paper in front on the screen and let's see how it looks. What's your name? Sorry, I can't see on the screen right now.
Ramesh. Is it Ramesh on the screen?
Ramesh, I'll just read.
Yeah, would you like to share? Ramesh, share on the screen.
Just copied your way of presentation.
So this is just a reference. You need to do your own. And once you've done that, try and give it a name. Like, for example, I find my mind very cluttered, my heart very overwhelmed, right? And my body feels very exhausted by the time I reach office. So that's what I've done. So you need to give a one word name to each image that you've created.
Excuse me, hello?
Yes.
It's becoming difficult to actually draw fear. How do I draw fear? I mean, I'm not a visual person, can you give a kind of hint or something?
So, just close your eyes, and what is it that you see when you think of fear, when you think of that situation and fear?
So fear goes in the heart or in the body? Because
heart. It goes everywhere, actually. What does it feel in your heart? How does it feel? Does it feel warm? Does it feel like fiery?
Okay. Heart beats faster and...
Yeah. So maybe you can draw red squiggly lines up and down.
Okay. Thank you so much.
And you can name it fear. I'd like to see a few people who've done it, so I know that everyone is on the right track.
Can we request everyone to keep the cameras on, please? We are not able to see you because this is kind of an interactive session. We want you to...
Yeah. We would want everyone to interact and share and benefit from it. Yes. Bushra's take. Okay.
Bushra's. Bushra. Okay. I have some family members who, when they come, I find very stressful when kids come and run around in the house. Okay. So this is like stress.
All right.
And I feel like somebody is hammering my head.
Right. That's nice.
And my heart is beating.
Okay. All right.
Fast.
So emotion is, in your heart. Yeah.
It is feeling very, it is anxiety. I can name it anxiety, yes. Okay. What will happen? And there is something, I don't know what in my stomach that happens.
Okay. Yeah. So,
so I've scribbled and I feel giddy.
Yeah. So what happens visually, we can represent ki kuch kuch hota hai. We don't have a word for it at times, but we can visually represent it. So that's nice. What you've done is very good. Try and give them names if you can.
So this is anxiety.
Right.
This is, I feel sensitive to sound, I think.
Okay.
So it will be sensitivity, right?
Sensitivity, okay.
And this is, I don't know what. I feel tired. I feel running, like running away out of the house.
Okay. All right.
Escape.
Okay, escape. All right.
Escape.
Anyone else would like to share? Anyone else, please? Okay, just speak about it. Please unmute and speak.
I did this. I thought about wanting to start something, as I said before.
Right. Right.
Yes. So in my mind, there are too many thoughts for me. Like, I want to start something, but I don't know from where will I be able to do it or not.
Okay.
So, gray, I use gray for crosses, as in, you know, those doubtful thoughts and stuff. And for blue, I used for emotional, because I get too emotional when I get those thoughts. And then yellow and red, because I get mad at myself for thinking those things, and yellow because there is a little bit of hope inside, still inside my mind, that is because of which I get my doubt. Then I named it overthinking.
Okay, overthinking for the head.
Yes. And for the heart, I used gray, red and blue inside it. Because as I said before, I feel mad at myself. I feel sad mostly, and gray because I feel dull. So I named it emotional, and around it there are green and red dots, which represent that there is, as I said before, that I have a little bit of hope, motivation, but I destroy it by just thinking too much. And then for the body, I did mostly it's red. And there are, in the place of eyes, there are blue dots, as in I get sad, emotional. I feel like crying, and I have cried. So, and mostly it's red because I feel exhausted. I feel like doing nothing. I know I have to do something, but I still don't do it. So I named it exhaustion or procrastination.
Okay. All right, good. Mr. Deepan wanted to share. Would you like to share? I saw him raising his hand.
It's really not share worthy, because even when I scribble, my heart is terrible.
If you can see. Okay. A little bit closer to the screen. I can't see clearly.
No, it's because the light is.
Okay. All right.
Reflecting,
would you like to talk about it?
Well, I could, but I was hoping you don't.
Your volume is a little low.
Okay. Is this better?
Yeah, it's better.
I was hoping you don't call on me, but
so the volume has gone back.
Okay, now better?
Yes.
So head is, you know, I've shown those things as if it's about to burst due to anger and you know, seething anger in me. So it is very specific about driving in Bombay, not anywhere else.
Okay. And heart?
Heart is it's beating faster, so it goes like this. Like tabak, 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 tap, 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 it goes fast. And in the body, it is, you know, I've shown the spiral in the in the abdomen region, the stomach region. Okay.
All right. What have you named them?
I haven't named them. It's just
put a word to them.
Anger and being upset.
Put a word to each one of them. See, what we've done right now is we've taken a stressful situation and seen it from a totally from a head, heart, and body perspective. And we've given it an external form. Now what, for example, I've said my head is cluttered. I'm not going to say my head is cluttered. Tell myself that there is clutter. See it as an external thing, right? Detach yourself, see it as an external object. Say that there is clutter. The head is cluttered, not my head is cluttered and I'm overwhelmed. There's the heart, the heart is overwhelmed. I am not overwhelmed, the heart is overwhelmed. Body is exhausted. Yeah, I am exhausted. Don't get into that, being consumed by that thought, emotion, or the bodily sensation. See it as an objective thing. See it from an objective perspective. Just take a look at what you've drawn and see. This is, in Buddhism, there is a complete meditation where you just label emotion, not saying that I'm angry or I'm frustrated, saying rather than that, saying there is anger. This is anger, this is frustration, this is pain. So you look at it from a very objective thing. When you have created an image which is outside of your body and mind and heart, you are able to see it objectively rather than being consumed by it. You're being able to see it from an external perspective. That's the idea of drawing this little doodle. Yeah, it's a very simple art, but that's the idea behind doing this. And as a, just take a look. How it is, how does it feel? Just at times, just taking a look at it, you get a completely different perspective. You get a holistic perspective on it. And certain things, at times, you have a shift in your perspective. Yeah. What we're going to do now is take another sheet of paper and again draw head, heart, and body in a similar manner. But this time you're going to draw how you would rather feel. How would, what is it, the kind of thoughts you want? I want my thoughts to be very clear. 1, 2, 3, ABC. I want my heart to be blossoming, right? I want my body to be energized. How is it that you want to feel in that situation? How is, what kind of thoughts you want and how will you represent them visually? Try and do that. Take a couple of minutes and do that. Very simply, go ahead and do that. And feel free to share and ask. This is an interactive session. Bring to a conscious awareness that particular stressful situation and turn it around in your mind.
Badal, we have a comment. Can you repeat it? I lost connection from one of our participants.
All right. I'm saying that earlier we did, what we did was earlier we created a head, heart, and body image of what is stressful in our, of that stressful situation. And we labeled them with one word. Now what we're going to do is take another fresh sheet, fold it into three, draw another head, heart, and body, and over it, visualize, think about how would you rather feel. Swing it to the complete extreme positive. I'd rather feel in while I'm driving, I don't want a clutter in my head. I want just maybe three important thoughts. You know, I want mental clarity. I want a heart which is blossoming rather than earlier it was overwhelmed. I don't want an overwhelmed heart. What is it that you'd rather feel? Blossom. I don't want pain in my body and exhaustion. I'd rather feel energized. Right? So you figure out in that particular situation, how would you rather feel? Swing it to the extreme positive. What is the kind of thoughts you would want in your head? How would you feel? And how would it feel in your body? represent it with very simple doodles, colors, squiggles, dots, lines, flowers. What would you feel like? How would you represent positivity with a color? Maybe fresh golden yellow or green, you know? Or a very loving pink or a bright orange. Once you've done that, label them again. When you label an image, first you create an image and when you label it, there's a left and right brain connection and it integrates very beautifully. If anyone's done, please feel free to share so I know what's if you've got it right.
Friends, we want everyone to share either by, you know, unmuting yourself and talking or switch on your camera.
Anybody who had earlier shared the stressful images would like to share the positive ones? Mr. Deepan, would you like to share? Unmute, please. Unmute, please.
Yeah, so yeah. Again, light will be a bit of a challenge, but I'll tell you. So I would like the head to be uncluttered, actually. That's the word I have chosen.
All right.
Heart to be peaceful.
Okay.
And body to be relaxed.
Body to be at rest.
Relaxed.
Yeah. Right. Instead of uncluttered, can you use a positive word? Uncluttered is a negative. Can you use maybe clarity, for instance?
Clarity, yeah.
Yeah. So because it's a completely positive thing, So we'll try and use positive words here. Anyone else would like to share? Yes, please. Please talk about it. I don't know your name because your name is appearing as Ashmita here on the screen. Please unmute and introduce yourself and share.
Yeah, my name is not Ashmita. I'm Devesh, and so I when I was doing it, I was getting more of words, positive words, than the drawing. Except that when I was thinking about my body, I wanted to be fit, so I could draw some muscles and okay. six abs. I could wow. Six lines I made on the stomach. This is a work situation, so I in terms of the head, I would like to be creative, positive, and persist in my work. In terms of my body, the words which came was energetic, taking initiative, feeling powerful and fit. And in terms of my heart, again, feeling positive, energetic, you know, yeah. And yeah.
Good. So thank you for sharing, Devesh. So again, what we've done is we've created an external object. So it's very easy for us to understand and kind of shift our perspective. Now, just visualize yourself being in that positive state. Take a minute to visualize in that positive state. Completely positive state in terms of head, heart, and body. Imagine that it's already happening.
So, may I speak?
Yes, please. Yes, please.
Yes, I have drawn something. Yes, I was previously it was sensitivity.
Okay.
And now the extreme goodness will be being relaxed and right. Being more creative. So I've made stars here.
All right.
So when the kids come, I should be already prepared with some activities for them. So that they're constructively using their energies.
Yeah. So that's your action point, that you have already be prepared with the activities, right?
Yes. And then I should be happy and full of love. So my heart is happy.
And how will you do that? Convert the heart from the earlier state to happy state? What action will you take?
Firstly, I should be mentally prepared that they are coming and it's not a threat.
All right.
So previously, I had that problem that if I know that somebody is very loud and they're coming to the house, I used to feel very, stressed out and, oh my God, now all the clutter and all the mess and all the noise. So now I want to know that it is okay.
Okay.
First of all, I need to calm myself.
Yeah, that feeling of the action is to accept, mentally accept it. So that gives you a feeling of calm. And in your body, how does that feel? How do you want to feel in the body?
Once my friend had told me that, Bushra, you need to make a bubble around yourself. It's an oval bubble.
Okay. It's a good it's a golden light.
Yes, it is my own happy place, my comfort zone. And nobody can break that bubble. It should be like that. So nobody can intrude. I feel secure. I'm not wanting to escape like in this picture before there was something I was feeling. So I don't want to feel that. I want to feel secure, calm and peaceful. And then,
very beautiful. Yes. And what action will you take to do that?
I think I need to play with those kids instead of just shouting at them. I need to involve.
So now what we're going to do is take a third sheet of paper and we're going to bridge our stressful situation with the positive situation with some action. You're going to take another sheet of paper, fold it into three and draw three green arrows and write one action each. We're going to bridge. This was the earlier stressful situation. This is the positive situation out of it and bridge with three action points, right? You're going to write, let's say for me, the driving experience, my mind was cluttered. I'm going to practice, my point of action is I'm going to practice 80-20 principles. So I'm going to focus on three important things for the day. So three important actions. So it's going to be clarity in my mind. In my heart, which is overwhelmed, I'm going to listen while driving, I'm going to listen to inspirational music so that my heart feels very blossomed, right? The third thing is my body is exhausted. So I've decided my action point is every morning during the breakfast, I have to have an energy drink. So the body remains energized. So similarly for you, what are the three action points you're going to take for these to convert the stressful situation into a positive situation? So draw three arrows and put it in between those two sheets.
So I want to say that we can also meditate before we are jumping into we know that a stressful situation is coming.
Yeah. So that's your action. That's your action point. Put it in the green arrow.
All right.
And would anyone like to share? Keep it a simple single action point for each arrow. If anyone's done, please share.
Hello.
Yes.
हाँ हूँ शैलजा मेहता छू आई एम शैलजा मेहता सर सब प्रॉब्लम
Miss Mehta, your camera is off right now.
Yeah, ma'am.
You can share, like, if you are not able to on your camera, your experience.
In the meantime, would anyone else like to share? Bushra or Kevna, because you've been sharing earlier, I'd like to see how you're progressing. Change you would like to share. Kevna, you done? Would you like to share? Please go ahead, unmute and share. Yes, please.
So, for the first arrow, I wrote that. Not pay attention to useless thoughts. Now, I wrote that in my mind, I want freshness.
Okay.
I dwell on the thoughts so much and I think a lot, I would rather want to not pay attention to them because there's no, now I cannot stop those thoughts. It's not in my hand. So what I can rather do is not pay attention to them and focus on what I want and start doing it.
Wonderful.
And for the heart, I wrote calm and confident.
Okay, good.
So I wrote that accept the emotion and take a step-by-step process. First of all, when I, in the heart, previously I wrote that I felt emotional. That is because I compared myself too much with the other artists who are already on a specific level. Now, I am a beginner. I cannot compare myself to someone who is already above me. I can take inspiration from them, but I cannot just compare my work with theirs. That actually demotivates me. So that is also a reason why I cannot start. So I also wrote a phrase that I can do it.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Stop comparing and you're saying I can do it.
Yes. And for the body, I wrote that I want to be motivated. Yeah, I wrote motivated. So for that, I wrote start working rather than just dreaming. Like, I want to become this, but if you just keep on dreaming that, there will be a point where everything becomes negative. And I also wrote a phrase with that. It's a challenge. Focus on yourself like that. So instead of, you know, comparing myself with those other artists, I would rather take inspiration from them and take it as a challenge. Like, if you can do that, I can do much better than you. If I want to compare, then I can do it like that instead of just demotivating myself. And I also want to focus on myself. So that's how I can overcome it.
Wonderful. Thanks for sharing, Kevna. That was wonderful. So all of us can see how our stressful situation, when we look at it objectively, in terms of head, heart, and body, and accept that situation, but so we pay attention to it. So we get a very objective feedback on it, right? And then this figure out what is that we intend, from attention to intention, and then we bridge it with an action, right? So it's a very simple way of processing a stressful situation and try at making attempt to convert into a positive one. There's no escaping action, but this therapy, this particular technique helps you move from negative to positive in any situation. So it's my urge to try again at home, pick up any stressful situation and try and convert it to positive in this way. What we've done is a very simple art therapy activity, and visualize after the end of it and try and integrate it in your body and promise yourself that you're going to take action steps, all three action steps, right? So what we noticed is that the process of creating this artwork as per the therapy connects head, heart, and hands. It connects your mind, body, and emotions in a very simple way. You're completely present to what is happening. You're not escaping. You're completely present in that moment to that situation. And you're working towards dealing and making it positive. We go from attention to intention, and we have action points for it, very, very clear action points, right? And what you've done is not created a very difficult work of art. It's just squiggle and doodle, and it's a simple self-expression, and which has given you new insights and new perspectives, right? And as Buddha said, everything is mind-made. So when we look at our mind and we make it positive, our life becomes very, very positive. And there's a shift in that space. Now, this is a very simple activity which we've done, very short activity, but allow me to share you with you about my upcoming workshop, where there are much more detailed activities, right? So what we do is, in the Zoetic Wellness Art Therapy Workshop, we work on the principle of positive psychology. We move from being normal to being brilliant, from being just good to being great, right? Helping us resolve many, many issues, which are mental, emotional issues. And no artistic skills are required, as you noticed today, right? It's very, very simple work, squiggles and doodles and coloring, which you do. So there are much more detailed specific activities, which are other activities for specific purpose. And you would just focus on authentic, spontaneous, creative self-expression. You don't need to be an artist to benefit from art therapy.
Badal, just a question, Ashmita here. Do we also have one-on-one art therapy session?
Yes. We also do one-on-one sessions. There are workshops as well and one-on-one sessions also. I'll speak about them in a little while, right? So in every art activity, there are simple step-by-step instructions given, and you follow that instructions and you experience the healing inside. And it's a completely 100% experiential workshop. As you noticed today, there's not much of theory. It's experiencing it and healing yourself. And you can use any art material, whether you use color pencils or sketch pens or crayons or watercolor, whatever you're comfortable with, right? And basically, in the workshop, we work in four different areas of your life. The first one is about self-love. First of all, whenever you are in any situation in life, first of all, we need to appreciate ourselves. We have to be well. Only then we can live a beautiful life, right? So the first session has three activities. The first one is about learning how to process pain and bring about mental peace. any painful situation in life, how do we process it with art therapy? How do we declutter our mind and bring clarity? And how do we radiate positivity? That's what you will learn in session number, first session, self-love and personal well-being. In the second session, we move on to learning about how do we deal with relationships? How do we heal relationships? Whether they're personal relationship or professional relationship. All of us face some stress in relationship. How do we deal with that? And how do we develop an expansive heart? How do we develop loving appreciation for people in our lives? So that's what we learn in the healing relationship session. The third session is about our mindset, about building an abundance mindset in our work and careers, you know. So we develop, first two sessions were working on love, self-love and loving relationship. So that's completely emotion-based. The third session, we are working on vision, developing an abundance mindset, developing a very clear vision of our life through creating artworks and focusing on how do we achieve goals. And also about, it gives you a completely new perspective on wealth. It activates 8 completely new different dimensions of wealth. That's what we learn in the abundance mindset session. The fourth session in the art therapy workshop is about mindfulness. How do we develop focus and concentration with the use of an art therapy activity? Like how we did initially when it was a breath, when we focus on breath and we do a upward pointing line and a down pointing line and we come into present moment and focus. Similarly, there are other activities which we will do in the mindfulness session, which will help us develop focus and concentration, which will help us deepen our awareness. We will get more meditative with creating simple works of art. And how does it combine our head and heart and into a space of loving kindness? So what we do is the four sessions. There is self-love session, there's healing relationship, there's abundance mindset and mindfulness. They are 2 hours each session on Saturdays, 4 Saturdays, 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. in the afternoon. The next batch is starting after Diwali, 13th of November, the first session, the second on 20th November, third on 27th November and fourth on 4th December. The details, I'd request Ashmita to share in the chat a link. If you wish to register, you can click on that link and register. All these activities are very simple activities. We're doing it lightheartedly, but we have a deep impact. You will see a lot of positive change in your life when you attend these workshops. And if you go onto my website, badalsuchak.com, and the wellness section, you will see a lot of testimonials of people who have attended the sessions earlier. And if you're inspired to take a leap from being normal to being amazing through this joyful creativity, you can register for the session today. And especially for Mindful Living community, just for today, there's a special discount. Usually the workshop costs 6,000 rupees, the 4 sessions. But just for today, it is 4,500 if you wish to register. So click on the link if Ashmita has shared. Have you shared, Ashmita, the link in the chat box?
Yes, yes. I have shared the Zoetic Art registration link. And after this link, I'm also going to share the feedback form. So if you can just give your time in the feedback form also.
So you'll see this poster in the link. And the if you click, you will be able to register just for today. And I would also request Ashmita to share the link later on your WhatsApp, if possible, or email, whatever is possible, Ashmita, after we complete the workshop.
Yes, we'll do that.
Yeah. And if you wish to connect with me, that's my mobile number. You can note it down. It's 9930301459. And you can also log on to my website and all the details are over there. There are videos and images and testimonials, and you can contact Ashmita or me to join. And I thank you really, thank you very much for your time. If you have any questions now, you may please go ahead and ask.
May I request everyone to, we already have the link of Zoetic Art registration. I'm also sharing a feedback form and also a WhatsApp group, community group. So every week we have Saturday, every week we have a session. So that you can join the WhatsApp group and we can keep you updated. And Mr. Badal Suchak is also part of our group. And there is a feedback form link so that you can give us your feedback and let us know how we can do it better. If you filled up the feedback form, you can just type FB. You can just type that.
If anyone wants to give a feedback now, how do they find the session? You may please unmute and start, turn on your video and share. What is the most important thing you got out of today's session you'd like to share? Most welcome. Ashmita asked me about the sessions, whether I do a one-on-one session.
Yes. One-on-one session, because there are many of them who would want to go for a one-on-one session.
Yes.
So if you can just share the details.
So there are one-on-one sessions also possible. If you have dealing with any particular issue in life, you want to find a resolution for it, you can contact me. I do one-on-one session for people who have a relationship issue, people who I've had clients who have gone through a lot of pain in life, abuses in life, who attend my sessions, art therapy sessions, and they find a good solution for the situation. People who want to figure out the life purpose, I help them with art therapy for figuring out life purpose and kind of figuring out step-by-step ways to achieve their goals in life. So various situations can be dealt with. A lot of couples come together, so they work together in art therapy to resolve, bring about resolution in their marital issues. So various things. Some people have had stressful childhood, so we work on inner child therapy through art. Yes. Any questions or any sharing, most welcome.
I wanted to make a small announcement. Next week, we do not have any sessions. Next Saturday, it's a Diwali week.
Ashna, you are muted. Unmute, please.
We wish everyone a happy Diwali and a prosperous new year. So please requesting everyone to join the WhatsApp community, please. If you can just kindly join.
All right. Thank you very much for being a part of this session. And I wish you a happy Diwali. And I hope that you benefited from this session. It is my heartfelt wish that you benefit. If you have any further queries, you can get in touch with me. Feel free to get in touch with me.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Ashmita.
Thank you so much. Thank you everyone for joining us today.
Happy Diwali.
Thank you.
Happy Diwali. Happy Diwali, Badal. Happy Diwali, Ashmita.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Good night.